Hello everyone, my name is Paulo Alves, and on the previous video I showed you what the idea of the Ionic Framework is. We also installed the Ionic Framework on our machines and we created our first project with it. This project is based on my new startup called Reciclica. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can click some here at the top of the video and then you're going to be redirected to the video where I explain everything about startup. But in this video here, we are going to get this project that I just created and we are going to go through all the directories of the project and files so we understand better how Ionic actually works in real life. Also, after that, I'm gonna push all that code to GitHub, to a public repository where you're gonna be able to download the application. You're gonna be able to comment, analyze, and copy to your computer if you want to do your changes or whatever you want to do with it. So let's start the video. So let's talk a little about the structure that was created for that project and the initial files that exist here also. First, we have this folder here called E2E, which means end to end. This folder exists so we can create tests that check if the application is behaving as it should. These end-to-end tests are nothing more than tests that simulate a real user using the application, meaning it will simulate the user entering the application, click some buttons, or making purchases, or anything like that. That looks pretty cool, right? But I'm gonna actually to delete this folder here because that kind of test, end-to-end, I do in another way with another framework, I mean, with another tool, but that tool is for later. Our goal here is just to talk about this project, so let's delete the folder. Okay, now we can see this folder here called Node Modules. This folder contains several libraries that are used by our project so that it can work. A library here in the IT world, for those who don't know, is a collection of codes that were written by other people and that we are reusing it instead of doing everything from scratch. Keep in mind that the code in this folder will never need to change. Then let's move on to the next folder called Source. This folder here contains all the code needed for the application to work. It's here where the magic happens and where we'll put our nerdy heads to make the app work. So let's break it down by subfolders. This app folder here is where the code of the application is. This whole source folder has a set of TypeScript, HTML, SCSS, and also SPEC.TS files, which are the test files. So alright, most of the code we write will stay here. This assets folder has some external things, let's say, like icons, images, and such. We also have a folder called environments, so I can have here multiple environments like production environment, testing, development environment, and so on. Now we have the theme folder, which has the theme of the app, of course, like colors and so on. I have a global.scss2 where I can put CSS code that will be visible through all the app. We have the index.html file, which is where everything starts. I have also some other files here that I think are not worth it going through them. All right, the next file of interest that we have is the angular.json file. This file contains some of the configurations that we use to develop and generate the build. I mean, to build the project into something that we can install, let's say, to be able to use it in the browser, or for us to create an Android package or an iOS package. Okay, usually you'll not have to change this file also, so let's then move to the next file, which is the ionic.conf.json. It only contains some basic settings of our project, for example, the name and the type of language that we are using on it. In this case, we are using Angular as the framework for development, all right? So usually you also don't have to change anything here, so let's keep going on. I'll go to the next file, which is the karma.conf.js. This file here is also a configuration file, which is used to run the test code that we'll make here so we know that our code doesn't fail, right? For us to be as sure as we can that nothing has broken after any changes we made to the code. An important thing for you to know is that in this project we are gonna develop everything using TDD, which stands for test-driven development, which in my opinion is actually the most correct and safe way on developing code. So let's move on to the next file of interest, which is the package.json. This file here contains some information about the project. It also contains a list of commands that we can run to create a build, to run the project, to test the project, for example, And down here, it shows the list of dependencies that you have in this project. We have production dependencies, let's say, and development dependencies. I mean, things that do not need to go into production. For example, TypeScript. I don't need it in production because in real life, the production code is JavaScript. It's not TypeScript. So these four last files here, which are 3ts.config and 1ts.lint, they let us make some configurations on how to use TypeScript in our project. TypeScript, by the way, is the language that we use to code the actions on our project, like button clicks, page changes, and everything else. All these files that end with .ts are TypeScript files, right? TypeScript is very similar to JavaScript, except that I can put types on my variables. Well, I mean, the biggest difference is that I can put types on my variables and objects and so on. But about TypeScript, we'll also talk later. Now, GitHub. GitHub, for those who don't know, is a tool where we can upload versions of our code, versions of anything we want, actually. We can upload them in repositories and then organize our project to make it easier for other people to download the project and make changes on their own computers, all right? So let's create a project on GitHub. I'm gonna go here in the new project and write the name of the project, which is Reciclica, and the description, which is recycling app. Cool. As I told you, the visibility of the project is going to be public. So any of you will be able to see everything I'm doing, post comments, give new ideas and such. And that's it. Let's create the project. Okay, I have created the project now, and what I have to do is to create a repository for it. I mean, the application-specific code will stay in that repository. Later, I'll create another repository for the website-specific code, for example, so I'll be able to have different repositories with different apps. One for the mobile application, one for the website application, another for the portal, so on. So let's create it. The repository name will be Reciclica app. The description is gonna be recycling app, also public visibility. I will add one README file here. This README file exists so we can explain how to install the project, for example. And then I will create the repository. Then I write, in case any of you want to have access to the Reciclica app code, just copy this URL here, come to the command line and type in git clone URL. What this is going to do is to get all the code that I have here in the project, which is now basically none. It's a file, right? The README file. And it's going to copy it to your machine. But for that, you will have to install this tool called Git. And then you hit enter. So you're cloning the code from the Reciclica app inside to your directory. But what happened was that I cloned it actually to a subfolder of my application here. Take a look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to that subfolder and I'm gonna copy everything inside it and put it on the parent folder. It will replace the files at the parent folder and then I can remove the subfolder. So, okay, here's my code. It turned green in order to show us that this code has an update that needs to be uploaded. The Git tool can see that this file here, for example, exists on my computer, but it doesn't exist in Git. So Git is letting me know that I have an update to make. And how do I do this update here in Visual Studio Code? Well, I can come here to the modifications tab that I have in the project. I'll select all the modifications I want to upload to Git. I will simply select everything here, all right? I click on the plus button, meaning these modifications are on stage, which means that they are almost ready to go to the master code, right? The parent code, I mean. Now I will put a comment explaining what the changes are. I'll put here Kickstarter. I'll click on the check, and what the check button does is to say like, okay, these changes are here on my computer and are ready to be taken to GitHub, but notice that they are still not on GitHub, as I may want to upload more than one operation at a given time, for example. I made three changes on my code and I want to upload all of them together. To be able to upload all the changes, I write here git push, meaning it will push the code I have here to Git. I click enter and that's it. Our code was uploaded to GitHub. If I come here on the GitHub page and I refresh it, we can already see all that structure that I created is here, okay? And that's it, everyone. Now we have already set up everything that we need to start developing the code of my new startup called Reciclica. And if you got interested in knowing what we are going to do later, how we are going to code the app, how we are going to promote it and everything, just hit the subscribe button, share with your IT friends and entrepreneur friends also, and see you on the next video.